Jumbo, or hello as we say here in Kenya. Thank you for giving me the chance to speak to you in beautiful Toronto today. Climate change and air pollution are the biggest environmental threats facing humanity today. Our planet is changing and we can all feel it. Last year, the North Pole of the Arctic was warmer than some parts of my home country, Norway. Just last week, the United Nations Security Council issued a historic warning. It said, climate change is one of the causes of the Somalia devastating conflict. And no matter where we live in the world, breathing clean air is becoming almost a luxury for many people. The good news, however, is that more of us are more dedicated than ever before to addressing these challenges. It's great to see that the Climate and Clean Air Coalition is expanding year by year. And we're getting bigger because we have accepted that there is no debate between economic growth and development. We can bring everyone out of poverty and protect Mother Earth at the same time. When we don't grow smarter and sustainably, we undermine and destroy the development gains. At risk are our children. Last year I visited Ulaanbaatar in Mongolia. Their children are found to have 40% lower lung function than children living in the rural areas of Mongolia. But while the risks are extraordinary, so too are the opportunities and actions that countries and cities are taking. China has shown tremendous progress in cleaning its air. As blue skies returned to Beijing this winter, people took to social media to talk about the excitement of being able to discard pollution masks for clean cities. Many countries in Europe are banning diesel vehicles, and India aims to be fully electric by 2030. Last year was the eighth in a row in which global investment in renewables exceeded $200 billion. The world now added more solar capacity than coal, gas and nuclear plants combined. We are clearly seeing the economic benefits of shifting to a better world. So I call on members of this great coalition to push us even further by helping us to improve our economies and take care of the planet at the same time. Let's raise our ambitions even further on paper and, of course, more importantly, in practice. Let's inspire people to act, because even the smallest change in daily life makes a difference and inspire others. Let's work closely with the private sector, because green business is good business. And let's encourage every city in the world to join the Breathe Life campaign. And importantly, let's showcase and celebrate innovations and ideas that are working in one city with many more. And let's see how we can scale up even further. I often surprise people by telling them I'm an incredible optimist. This is because time and time again in history, human creativity has risen to solve so many challenges, even bigger challenges than climate change and environment destruction. And I see no reason why that can't happen again. But for this, we need to come together and treat what's happening on our planet as a global emergency. We cannot wait for global agreements. Each of us must act today, and act quickly, individually, as nations and in business. Only then will we be able to transform our world and build a better future for all, because we simply have no other choice. I look so much forward to hearing more about the discussions in Toronto. UN Environment is committed to supporting you and the journey ahead.